x here, okay, then y, this should be true. So y that should belong to some an actually. So think about it. Hey, so are you going to think for yourself? Would you like to think for yourself? You don't want to think for yourself. So take an x, take an arbitrary x, and apply fm onto it actually. It's a number. It's a number. Okay? It's a number. And I can do what? So if fn of x is number, then y...
Sorry, varte prati infinity approaching.
Okay, that's intuition. That is going to exhaust everything.
Sir, for any x, s of x is less than f of x. Is it true?
Yes. S of x is...
less than f of x.
F of x, so...
Now, I can find some c in 0 and 1, which is less than for any n, fn of x would be greater than c s of x.
Okay. Because I can also see this as a limit. Yes. N goes to infinity.
So there must exist fn in between s of x and f of x.
So I'm saying that since these two guys are equal, and yes, this sir. Is bigger than or equal to s of x, then I can find some n
for which
fn of x is bigger than or equal to s of
yes,
x.
Yes.
Okay? But it need to be made rigorous actually.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you got some intuition, but it need to be made rigorous. And you know, for that n, this x is going to be in
A.
And
hence,
you know, in fact there'll be, you know, lots of A's in which there'll be that x, not just one. So you have this. Okay? Good. Now if this is the case, then consider the integral of fn. Okay? The integral of fn is bigger than or equal to the integral of fn over an. You agree? Because in the integral of f over whole x, you have, so I can split it into the two parts actually. Okay, so one part, the integral over a, and then the complement, and you have this. So this must be bigger than. But since each of the fn is bigger than or equal to cs of x, so I can say that I can estimate this by csn, okay, csn but over an.
S of x.
How many s of x? When you are writing integral, you don't need to write x.
No, but not the subscript n.
What do you mean by that?
No. Subscript n.
So fn in general.
Sn.
So I'm saying that we proved that if f of x is less than or equal to g of x, then integral of f is less than or equal to integral of g. There is no need to put x actually.
S is arbitrary.
S is arbitrary. Okay. S is arbitrary. Yes, you are right. Not Sn actually, but S is arbitrary. But this is equal to what? So this is equal to C times of the integral. And what was S? S is this guy. So it's going to be I equal to 1 to M AI. The measure of A
I intersection with A.
A I intersection with
A.
A n actually. Okay. Then I think we should use a different notation here. Okay. So let's use E as. Okay. Not A n, because otherwise we can confuse this. So you're gonna get this is equal to an intersection
A
in EIs, where I runs from 1 to n. ठीक हो गया जी. And then we can do what? Let's take it when m goes to infinity, or maybe m goes to infinity. So let's take limit m goes to infinity. On both sides. What are you gonna get? So I can take this and substitute it here. So you're gonna get AI times the integral of, you know, indicator function of AI over AN actually. So I can rewrite this integral as X times the indicator function of AN. I can do this. Okay. So, we do what? This is what? If I take n goes to infinity, what would be this side? So let's take the n goes to infinity on both sides. Limit n goes to infinity is going to be bigger than or equal to the limit of this guy. And this is what? This is L. So take the limit on both sides. So on this side I'm going to get L. Bigger than or equal to, what I'm going to get on other side? See, as n goes to infinity. So that's an is getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger.
X.
Okay, so what are you going to get?
X.
What are you going to get? You're going to get?
EI is equal.
The whole EI is at?
Yes, sir.
The whole EI is X. Whole EI is?
Maybe EI is a subset of X.
No. So in other words, I'm gonna get this. Let's try to figure it out.
So
why?
X, A, and
C times of integral of simple function.
मतलब ये लोग intersection X की तरफ है.
So why this will be the case? So as n gets bigger and bigger and bigger, the A n will get what?
Will go to X, sir.
It will go to the X.
Yes, sir.
And if you have, it will go to the X, then X intersection EI is going to be EI itself, because EI is a subset of X. And then the integral of AI and the measure of EI is going to give you.
Integral over
what?
Over whole X over
EI? Whole X over. So this is going to be the integral over whole X. So when I'm not writing something, it's integral over whole X. So in arbitrary, so we proved that the L is bigger than or equal to an arbitrary C multiplied by S actually. What should I do next? So for any C, this is true. Then I would say that this is true in general.
So, not for any C, for C belongs to
0 to 1. 0 to 1, obviously 0 to 1. How can I follow that if this is true, then this is also true in general?
Sir,
C is
0, 1.
So this is a number which is smaller than C. Okay? So it's like a C. If C is a number between 0 to 1 and you're multiplying this number with integral A, and this is true for all C's, you know, between 0 to 1, then even if you remove C, this is still going to be true.
Yes, sir.
And then if L is bigger than or equal to this, then my claim is that L is bigger than or equal to the integral of F. why this will be the case. It's a test for your real analysis. Think that how much of that you remember.
For arbitrary, yes.
F is their supremum. So,
if it's true for arbitrary,
Yunus must know the answer for this. Yunus, I'm expecting that it must be the only you who can give the answer of this question. Yes, because if L is bigger than or equal to, you know, an arbitrary S which is less than or equal to F and their integral, then L is an upper bound for set of all such simple functions. And then every upper bound is less than or equal to, bigger than or equal to these upper bounds. After this.